We all know that diversification is the best medicine against risk. Most bankers and investors follow a diversification strategy. Not putting all eggs in one basket makes sense. Risk is the uncertainty about the future. But we need to be precise for our model. We will look at stock returns but could also have taken default rates in a loan portfolio. We define risk as the standard deviation of the annual returns. We see that in portfolios the risk is mitigated with an increase of portfolio elements. The more the merrier. The portfolio risk shrinks with an increase of the number of constituents. The risk follows this formula. The little wave in the formula indicates proportionality. Let's look at an example. Say you have a portfolio of one stock. And we have 100 shares of company A. The risk or standard deviation of the annual returns is 10%. We often use the Greek letter sigma to express the risk. Now we diversify our portfolio and split it up in a portfolio of shares A, B, C, and D. We hold 25 shares of each stock. To keep it simple, we assume that these shares all have the same price and risk levels. And that the stocks are not correlated. Instead of just one stock A, we now hold four different stocks. The square root of the number of portfolio constituents is 2. That means that our risk is reduced by 1 over 2. If we could find 100 different stocks with the same price and risk levels, that would be great. The risk would shrink to 1/10 of the original standard deviation. Again, this effect only works when there is no correlation between these stocks. In practice, it will be hard to find such a portfolio. Even with high portfolio correlation, there is a portfolio benefit if this correlation is less than 100%. So, most banks will choose for a diversification strategy. Some, though, will opt for a different approach. There are banks that focus on one sector. They claim that this focus brings them superior insight and knowledge of this market segment. This way they might get better yields and less defaults. Still, most banks will seek the diversification benefits. Now we will look at two simple risk management tools, the correlation matrix and the Herfindahl-Hirschman Index or HHI. We start with correlation, and we steer away from complicated definitions. Correlation is the degree of relationship between variables. This could be a causal relationship, or not. We measure correlation on a scale of -1 through +1. A negative correlation shows the relationship is in the opposite directions. For instance, the internet growth and the decline of the traditional postal services. An example of a positive correlation would be the rise of the internet and the sales of smartphones. Correlation coefficients close to zero show there is no relationship. We can find the correlation in Excel using the CORREL function. In mathematical and financial articles, the Greek letter rho denotes the correlation. Let's look at an Excel example. We have 10 years of data for A and B. These data could be, for instance, stock returns or probability of default rates on bank loans. The Excel function is easy enough. We see that the correlation is 0.97, so close to 1. This is a strong correlation. Excel has another correlation tool in the data analysis tools. To use this toolkit, make sure to install the data analysis add-in first. This correlation tool calculates the coefficients of many data ranges in one shot. The Excel tool is self-explanatory. The result is a matrix with the correlations between all the portfolio constituents. The values along the diagonal axis in the middle all equal to 1. The portfolio elements are of course 100% correlated with themselves. In our example we see that D has a negative correlation with the other constituents. A diversification strategy calls for small or negative correlations. Surveying and analyzing these correlations are part of proper risk management. A second tool to track concentration risk is the Herfindahl-Hirschman Index or HHI. This HHI measures the degree of diversification, or if you like, concentration. The calculation is straightforward and simple. First, we need to choose a segmentation and calculate the shares in percentages. We multiply the percentages with 100 to get whole numbers. We square these whole numbers. The sum of squares is the HHI. In our Excel example, we have 5 market segments. The HHI is 2,900. To interpret this number, we look at the best and worst HHI cases. With 5 segments of each 20% share, we end up with an HHI of 2,000. This would be the best case with optimal diversification. The worst case is 100% in one segment, and 0% in the remaining sectors. There is no diversification. This produces an HHI of 10,000. We should aim for the 2,000 to achieve diversification. The HHI's value may not be so much in the number, but rather in the direction it moves over time. HHI offers a clear and uncomplicated instrument to follow and discuss diversification.